Hello, it's Kevin Bacon, and this is the third installment in the walking stick build. And that is the finial that I built for the top, and I made it to look like a snake head in a rough fashion. And it just contours right into the rest of the body, and it's glued on there with epoxy and a dowel. And the epoxy has yellow glitter mixed in with it, so if the light's just right, it kind of glistens. And we have, of course, there's a hole. There's something going in that hole. That's a surprise. And I even put the little rubber booty thing down on the bottom. But it will come off while I do the finishing. And that's what we're going to talk about in this video. We're going to talk about the finish. Now, there are various different kinds of finish we can use. And I tested a bunch of it. And I'm going to show you some of the tests. Okay, well, I tried some walnut stain. And the grain just does not shine through that very well. And I tried some antique maple stain. Once again, can't see the grain. I tried some clear acrylic, and it's not too bad, but it leaves the wood a little too blonde. And then I got the teak oil out. And now that's not sanded or anything, and that teak oil really makes that grain show through. And it makes it a nice dark wood. So that's what I'm going to put on it. I'm going to put a couple of coats of teak oil on it, and then after I get a couple of coats of teak oil on it and get it rubbed down, then I will coat it with acrylic lacquer on the top. But teak oil is unbelievably durable. I mean, it's the stuff that you would put on your deck. The only reason that I will put the acrylic on there is to keep it from being snaggy. You know, it gives it that final smooth finish. May not need it. The teak oil might do the job. But I want you to notice that, if you can, that I'm not doing a perfect finish job on this. I leave some little divots from the sanding and stuff to give this character so that it doesn't look as though it was manufactured someplace in a factory. But also, it just it just gives it a character that's different than you would find if it was built by a machine. Well, anyway, I'm going to put a couple coats of teak oil on it. I've still got to put some initials and stuff on it, but I will wait till the first coat of teak oil gets done. Then I will add lettering and other accoutrements after that. So let's throw some teak oil on here and see what she looks like. Okay, it's wet. I just put the teak oil on. You can see the distinctive line between where the Osage hedge ends and the sycamore begins. And I really, really hope that some of this beautiful grain jumps out in this lighting. This is a lot of bending for an old man. Okay, it gives you some idea, and it's still nice and dark, but look at the gorgeous accents where the grain shows through and the fire. I'll have to try to take some still pictures of this, and we'll get them up on the Porcupine Forge Facebook page. If you haven't gone over and liked my Facebook page, oh, I lost it. I post a lot of pictures of my projects up there. Just really, really nice. The really gorgeous stuff is right here, and I just can't seem to get it to... show up. Anyway, makes a very, very handsome staff. It's just right about 54 inches tall, give or take a couple inches. And very, very comfortable. So, we'll put two or three coats of this stuff on here over the next couple of days and get some lettering on it. And then get the special surprise in that hole, and it should be ready to go. Now, we've got to get to that other one. Oh, I see some of that glitter glittering in the epoxy there. Yeah, starting to show up. Well, that's good. That's what it's there for. All right. That's it for this particular video. Come make it. Bye for now.